I never thought I'd see the day that I'd say they've officially killed porn. All right? You're talking to a guy that's born in the 80s and 90s, and all we would have is an old magazine out in the canyon that we had to get, like, directions, and it got passed down generation to generation. We'd go out there and just stare at it. We didn't even know what to do. You know what I mean? We'd just stare at it and be like, oh, my God, titties. This is amazing. And then the only other option we had was that the cable box had 99 channels on it. You had to put it in between the 1 and the 99, and maybe you'd see a titty or two. But the one thing I liked about 80s porns is those people sounded like they were having a great time. And I just remember looking at that stuff. I didn't even know what to do with my little pee-pee yet, but I'd just look at it and be like, oh, man, I want to be that person. You know what I'm saying? I want to be that, you know? And nowadays, with this porn, all you got is what I like to call it is Hulk with a hard-on just walking in a room, and I don't care what genre you're in, nobody's holes, nobody's butthole, nobody's cooter, nobody's mouth hole is safe, because Hulk with a hard-on is just smashing everything, and it's just, that ain't sex, guys. That ain't sex. It reminds me of one time I was talking to a guy, and it was my friend, and I was telling him, like, how I get connected with the girls, and how I like to, like, make them come, and how the connection we get, and he just didn't get it. He was just like, what are you talking about, man? He's like, sex is just sex for me. It just, you know, I go do it. It's fun. I jike it. But, I mean, it's not like that. And then he ran across one of these women from a Buddhist. And, you know, she's very into spiritual things and stuff. And she was able to touch his heart. And after that, he came to me. He said, Mike, I see what you're saying now. He was 30-something years old. So some of you people just haven't really been explained to or seen it and been so programmed to be like, you know, that's what you're supposed to do. Just big, giant man, go smash booty hole, you know? And that's not it. You can connect with these people, your partners, whatever genre you're in, as long as it's above 18, legal site online, by the way. Yeah, you can connect. And once you find that connection, it's great. And I've had people be like, whoa, Mike, like, I feel connected to you, and our connection is awesome. She's like, I'm able to finish, you know, I'm able to terminate. No. And I'm like, yeah, me too. I was like, and then after a while, when you really get that connection, it almost becomes like a wrestling match, man. You guys are like, I'm going to make you come, I'm gonna make you come. You guys are, rah, rah, rah. And then you just, your orgasms get better, and it becomes great. So that is the type of sex I have. Also, when I do have sex, it's a whole, like, I go into a meditation. The world is blocked out. I'm not sitting there worrying about, is she having a good time? Because if I meet somebody I'm not having a connection with, I don't care how beautiful they are, it's not going to last. I had one girl look like Kim Kardashian, for real, dude. But I'm talking about ba-boom, ba-bam. I mean, it was, and I cracked her one time, but it freaked her out. It freaked her out because of all the past relationships she's had that have broke her. So sometimes when you get in that sensitive area and you do crack them, and then you can feel it too. You can feel it when another person kind of just, and you connect with them. You're like, yeah, you get it. You don't even have to talk to them. You're like, you're almost same mind. You're like, yeah, you get it. You understand? Yeah, like that. Mm-hmm. And you guys don't have to talk. That's why when these people are, it's like you're breaking your connection. That's why the other day I got on porn, look at some porn. I woke up in the morning, had a little chubby. I was like, oh, I'll work it out. Next thing I know, I start thinking about, like, what do I want to eat for lunch? And I just put my phone down and go. I don't even do it. And then this morning I woke up and I wanted to do it. And I was like, oh, it's just too much work. You know? Luckily, they still have those 80s porn so I can look at. I still look at those, you know, the ones where, you know, the person is, you know, their husband left them, life's tattered, and they're just frustrated, and then their friend leaves the phone number on the counter and is like, just call and order an extra, extra large pepperoni, and then the pizza boy comes over and gives them the pepperoni, and then they have that music with the saxophone, and they're like, those people really need it. Like, you see the best BJ scene you ever seen in your life. You're just like, I remember being a kid, just like, I want that. That's what I want. And, you know, I don't care what you're into now. They got it all. But this stuff has been corrupted. I never thought I'd see the day where I say, porn. But it's here. 2020, they were ruining what? Sports? Music? Rap music especially. You know? Now they've ruined porn. It's just generic BS. So hopefully this helps your sexual experience to try to find a connection with that person. Because when you do, when I have sex, I feel like I'm in a meditation. There's nothing in my mind. I clear my mind. I am with that person. We're connected and we have good sex. And after I finish, I feel as if I've rejuvenated my body. That's the type of sex I have. I don't know about y'all, but you got to start looking at yourself. If you're not having that type of mind-blowing sex, I feel bad for you, son, because I got 99 problems, but getting laid ain't one. Peace out.